Good morning, everyone. Today, we'll begin with a new topic, that is resources and development, right? Now, before we begin with this topic, let's talk about what actually a resource is. A resource means anything which is available in the environment and which can be accessed easily and feasibly is termed as a resource. Everything which is available in our environment and can be accessed easily and feasibly is termed as a resource. Anything which is available in the environment and which can be used to satisfy our needs and can be accessed easily and feasibly with the help of technology is termed as a resource. All materials available in our environment which satisfy our needs are called as resource. All resources have some value, true. Value means worth. Some resources have economic value and some do not. But both are important and satisfy human needs. Some resources can become economically valuable with time, like oil, petroleum. Time and technology are the important factors that change substances into people, themselves are the most important resource. It is their ideas, knowledge, inventions, and discoveries that lead to the creation of more resources. Definitely, you know, human beings, they interact with nature with the help of technology to create, to develop resources. Human beings, they interact with nature with the help of technology to develop resources. For example, it is humans, right, who with the help of their skilled mind and knowledge, right, they interact with nature. They dig up the oil wells, petroleum wells, right? They take out the raw petroleum, right? That raw petroleum is taken out and brought into petroleum refineries, where it is converted into fine petroleum, which can be used for consumption, and it is sold in the market, right? And also, you know, a lot of economic value is increased of the country, right? We are there in profit. We gain a lot of profit with this. So human beings, they even interact with nature with the help of technology, right, to develop resources. Each discovery or invention leads to many others. For example, discovery of fire led to the practice of cooking. Invention of the wheel resulted in the development of newer models of transport. Now, types of resources. Now, we can classify resources into natural, human, and man-made. Right? These are the three categories in which the resources can be classified. Now, let's talk about natural resources first. Natural resources are those resources that are drawn from nature and are used without much modification. For example, air, water, soils, minerals are the natural resources. Natural resources are classified into groups depending upon their level of development and use, origin, renewability, and distribution. Natural resources are also called gift of nature. Why? Because we derive them from nature. On the basis of origin, biotic, abiotic, living and non-living things. So biotic resources, These are obtained from biosphere and have life such as human beings, flora and fauna, fisheries, livestock, etc. Abiotic resources, all those things which are composed of non-living things are called abiotic resources. For example, rocks and metals. On the basis of renewability, they are of two types. The one which can be renewed and the one which cannot be renewed. Right? Means the ones which are inexhaustible and the ones which will get exhaust over time. With their use, they will get exhausted one day. They will no longer be available. So the resources that can be renewed or replenished quickly are called the renewable resources. The resources are unlimited, for example, solar, water, wind energy. Non-renewable or exhaustible resources. Resources which take thousands of years to get replenished are called renewable resources. Means the one which cannot be renewed within one lifespan are called non-renewable resources. The resources which cannot be renewed in a lifetime are called non-renewable resources. Now class, you will go through all the slides, right? Once you go through all the slides, if any query is there, do message me on your WhatsApp group. Fine. And your homework will be shared to you people on the WhatsApp group itself. Thank you.